this is an elephant. Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of Planet Zoo and Pine Brook Sanctuary. I hope you're all good and I hope you're all doing well. So this is our last episode of Pine Brook Sanctuary. So it's a little sad, but we've got plenty to do today. We have, I think, 4 pregnant gorillas, which is very exciting. So we will take a look at them very shortly. But overall, the zoo is doing very, very well. We are going to be putting in our large kind of habitat, the one with the Indian elephant, the tapir and the proboscis monkey. So that's going to be going all along in here. So hopefully I have a really good view for all of the guests that are going to be walking along here. I'm hoping none of them are shy because I'm thinking it's going to probably need quite big windows in it because of the elephant being so big. So that is the plan today, is to fill this area and finish off the zoo. So let's just take a look at the zoo. So we have low welfare for our lemurs. That's perfectly fine. We know that they're a little bit upset because they are just so popular. We have also had our okapi grow up. Is it this one? No. No, this one. Always the last one that you click on. They're fighting, quick. Let's send this one to the wild. Let's take them off of contraception, release this one to the wild straight away. You get 26 credits for this one. So there you are. So that will stop the fighting because we don't like them doing that. The rides seem to be doing okay, which is really good. This one's a little bit quieter, but everywhere else is really busy. Let's have a look at this one. Yeah, this one's really busy. They're pretty much queuing outside of the actual queue. So that's really cool. Yeah, and this one's also doing really well. Really pleased with these, actually. Oh, what's broken down? One of the vending machines, so we can get a mechanic on that. Horse is about to have offspring, which is exciting. Let's have a little look. Ah, there you are. So is it just one? Yes, I think it's just one. I think they can only have one. How cute is that? Look, oh, it's gone already. Oh, they're hungry, quick. So yeah, look at this. Got another little pea horse, which is really exciting. So the pea horse is having another baby, which is excellent. So how are we doing animal wise? Penguins, perfectly fine. I did already go through and sort out the exhibit animals. So our ama leopard, we have a male and a female. Oh, that was it, wasn't it? We've got a female waiting in the trade center so they can mate with the son. Tapirs are elderly, but also just expecting a baby. We have all of our Bengal tiger babies, which are exciting. Aren't expecting any other ones at the moment. Lemurs are sad, but we already know why. We've had quite a few little baby lemurs, which is exciting. Bonobos, they've calmed down a little bit now. but they're all doing well with their babies. What's this? Dangerous animal has escaped. Oh dear. How? How did you get there? Oh, you're not even escaped. No, you're still in your habitat. You haven't escaped, have you? No, you haven't. This is where you live. Okay. Fine. I'm just going to call the vet then because... Oh no, please don't run. Okay. Probably not the best choice just to call the vet. But you haven't technically escaped. I don't understand. Yeah, look, see? Just wandered off perfectly fine. I wonder if it was just like their arm or something that had gone through the fence. This is when you know your zoo is very big because... things start happening, like the game tells you animals have escaped and they actually haven't, or animals just walk out of their habitats like the Amur leopard did that episode. Okay, I'm just having another look at the animals then. So whilst it's tipping down with rain in the background, where did we get to? The dolls, all good there. Giant otters, we sorted them out a couple of episodes ago, so they're perfectly fine. Now leechweeds have had some babies by the looks of it, so we can put them on contraception, and also couple are expecting. Oh no, three are expecting, so that's exciting. Okapis are perfectly fine. Our horses are expecting another baby, which we just figured out. Oh, the red panda. Have we got another red panda? I'll have a look at that in a second. Because at the moment there's only one in there and that's really sad. Lemurs are fine. Oryxes are having babies, which is excellent and all good. Saramangs are now back in the habitat where they're supposed to be. Siberian tigers still not had a baby, but we do have the male in there now. because the male, I'll show you in a moment, but the male wouldn't come out of the trade center in the last episode, and in the end I had to like delete the paths leading to the trade center and like re-put them in. So yeah, that was a bit stressful. Yes, so our gorillas, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 babies due, all in year 80 and 81. I'm sure this one will be expecting very soon, so we should have lots of baby gorillas, which is really cool. And we have our water buffalo is expecting again, but the mothers are elderly, so we're just gonna have to keep a little eye on them. So let's have a look at our tiger, and then we'll have a look at the red panda. So this is the male Siberian tiger. So it's lovely of him to join us. I don't think he wanted to be put in the habitat, but look at how nice it is, sir. So there you are. So hopefully we should have some Siberian tiger babies in here very shortly. Okay, so we have a female red panda, but that is the daughter of our current red pandas. So that's not gonna work. So I'm thinking if we rehome this one, then we can put two new ones in. First of all though, let's go on over and have a little look and see if we can find any red pandas. Okay, so the best one that we have is this one here. Everything else is really, really low fertility, like zero. So I'm gonna grab this one whilst we can. I'm gonna send this one to the zoo by putting it in our quarantine area. That one I don't trust, because that was the one that the tiger got stuck in. What other ones have we got, just out of interest? Okay, we'll just use this one here. We haven't had any problems with that one. So what I'm going to do is go back over here and rehome this little guy. Oh, it's because they're technically elderly. Okay, so what we'll do is then we'll release this one to the wild. So that is sorted. Then we can come over here and we can grab this red panda and we can send this one to the zoo if we can find where the red pandas are. Oh yeah, here. So we can put that one in there. And then once the male comes out of the trade center, no, the quarantine, then all will be right with the red pandas. There you are. There is the female red panda. The red pandas are now back to how they were. Okay, so our female gorilla is just about to have a baby. There we are, look. Quick. Oh, look. I think it might be just the one baby. Look at its little face. And it's so tiny. Okay, so what have we got then? So we've got a little boy. Okay, so all of the females are now pregnant. So the daddy gorilla did not hang around at all, did they? So let's have a little look then at the animals that are actually going to be going in here. So we want the Indian elephant. Let's just pause the game just in case things start kicking off in the background. So we can have one male and 29 females. Okay, they are confident with humans, so that's excellent. And they can have one baby elephant. It's not going to be a case of us having 29 females, because that's just going to be mad. But because the habitat is really large, I am thinking we could probably get maybe three. That'd be one male and three females. I think that'd be quite good. So here are the animals that are going to be going in with the elephant. So we have the Malayan tapir, and that's one male and one female. Oh, I really thought it was going to be more than that. Okay. neutral relationship with humans, and they only have one offspring. Okay. So that's fine. It will just be one male and one female. So 9 males and 18 females, they're confident with humans, and they only have one baby. So, okay, I am thinking then, maybe what about 5 males and 5 females? Okay, one alpha per group. Okay, so let's go over and have a little look then at the trade center and see if we can find these animals. Now, I have a feeling it's going to be harder than we think it is to try and get all these animals. So let's start off then with the Indian elephant. This one is really good, but very, very expensive. This one's not too bad. Let's grab this one for our male. And then these 3 females. Not great genetics for these two, but there isn't that many of them. So I think we're just going to have to go with them. Now, as for the tapir, let's have a look at these. So these were one of each. Okay, this one's not too bad, and it's the youngest. So we'll grab this one. Now, the fertility for the male is generally quite low. But this one is better genes overall, and it is the youngest. So we'll grab this one as well. Okay, and then the proboscis monkey, I think it is. Yeah, see, I knew this was going to be cause us the trouble. So it may be then for now, because we only get one alpha and one female, the male is really quite good. So for now, I'm thinking then maybe we just get one male and then a lot of females. So I'm just going to grab all of these and we'll go from there. So let's just go and grab them all from our animal storage like that. And then we are going to send them to the zoo. Let's put them in this one here. So whilst they are all getting checked out, let's just have a little look at our research. And oh, we've just had another baby gorilla. Oh, okay, so this one is a little girl. So let's have a little look at her. Oh, look! They are just so cute, aren't they? And they're all standing up. That is very exciting. And I think the guests seem to really be liking these gorillas. Look at them all. Exciting. Oh, look, ready for the snow. So we've got a lot of people actually queuing for our restaurant, which is really cool. There are empty tables though, so I don't know why they're queuing, but each to their own. These guys are looking very cold outside. Oh, okay, so now that it has stopped snowing, let's get on with building this habitat. So I will catch you in just a moment. Okay, everybody, we have now finished the entire habitat. So we're just having a few more animals appearing in the zoo. So as you can see, it is a very, very big habitat. Now, I built the habitat before putting any animals in, and I seriously overestimated the size of the animals. So what I've done is I've put in a few more elephants and a few more proboscis monkeys. I haven't had any more tapirs because they can only have one male and one female. So we've got more elephants and we've got more monkeys in here. So we have a large water area over here for them. And then over here, we kind of have their sheltered area with a little bit of kind of enrichment in this section here. And then over here is where the guests can view the entire habitat. So they get quite close to the glass as well, so they can view the entire habitat in a kind of 360 view kind of thing. This is where that the guests enter, so they're starting to come through now. But there is glass panels pretty much the entire length of the habitat. Let's actually have a little bit more of an in-depth look at the habitat. So let me just pause this a second so we don't get anything popping up. So this is where they're gonna have all their kind of food. Come through here, you've got a little bit of a water enrichment. Over here, you have some more food enrichment, the view of the restaurant as well. And then you have some little climbing frames for the monkeys. Come through here, through the trees. And you have some more enrichment over here, some more water kind of fountains as well. You've got your little kind of leaf that the tapirs can use, along with balls and ice sculpture kind of enrichments. You have a little mirror for the monkeys and some little mud area for the elephants and the tapirs. You've got another water enrichment, which I don't think has any power, unfortunately, but there isn't anywhere else that can put another kind of power over here, unfortunately, so we'll just pretend that kind of works. Over here, you've got a little bit more of a kind of open space for them. We have the wheel, I think. I don't really know what that's called, but the elephants kind of push it along with their trunks. And then you have another climbing frame for the monkeys. And then coming around in this area, we've got lots more enrichment and a little pond area for the monkeys, I believe, or the tapirs, one of them. And then this is the little inside area. So it's nothing amazing in here. Just kind of really quickly threw it together. So we've got four big windows here so the guests can see in and the animals can see out. Ventilation up in here. The sides here and on here as well are open just for a little bit more ventilation, and you've just got their bedding on the ground there. I've put in one-way windows so hopefully the animals don't get too stressed. And over back over this side we've got some more climbing enrichment for the monkeys, but all the animals do use the kind of river that's kind of going through here. What is this? Oh. This is an elephant. I don't really know what's happening there. There we are, up the right way now. So all the elephants really love the water and so do the tapirs. So let's have a little look at this elephant here once it gets out of the water. Oh dear. So here we are, so we have an Indian elephant in here. Careful we don't trample the monkey. So yeah, so the guests can get a really good view of them because they come straight by the window. So that is really good. And we also have the monkeys as well. So this is the one of the females. So everything's going to be kind of big compared to them, because we have two big, bigger animals, I should say, in here with them. And this is one of the tapirs as well. So a little bit different kind of pattern to our other one. This one is kind of black and white, but they love the water as well. So there we are, you can see, sorry about the rain. And I'll just see if I can find the male monkey for you. And here you are, and here is the male monkey. They've got a quite a big nose, but they're enjoying the shelter at the moment. So this is the habitat. Everybody really likes the water and everybody seems to be really happy in here. Keeper's just coming in to give them their food. So this is it really. There is nothing left for me to kind of do with this zoo. It's getting very, very big now. So as you can probably tell, it's kind of lagging a little bit in the gameplay. The kind of frame rate slows down a little bit. So I think we're gonna call this season a day. But we do have Disney Dreamlight Valley coming. So if you are excited for that, please give the video a thumbs up. And also if you have enjoyed this series, please give it a thumbs up. I do really hope you have enjoyed this particular zoo. Thank you so much for any ideas and suggestions that you have had. It really does mean a lot. Keep making suggestions for any kind of zoos that you want in the future, any games that you particularly want. It's always great to hear your suggestions. So subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already, and I will see you in the next season, whatever it may be. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.